Alrighty, round two here. We're on the play. And this hand... For a second, I thought I had all mountains. Well, with the plains, it's obviously great. I was about to say, this hand I think is a mulligan, if I had all mountains. But since I don't, we will keep. Mostly because this card, if you're not suspending it early, it's not that great. Also, if I like drew a plains off of an all mountain hand, I'm not even pumping it very much. So my first play is like a fortune thief, morphed, and I'm really just not doing much conflagrate. As it stands, I get to suspend this turn one into a turn three fortune thief and apply some good pressure. So all around a nice hand. Play this. Seems like our opponent might be a little better equipped to kill our fortune thief than the blue-green there, although the blue-green player had more ways to kill a fortune thief than you would think at first glance. Playing a plains because we have a pumper. Get our battle on here. So this is gonna unsuspend. I think I just attack with both, playing my land. If they block, it's certainly annoying, but it's not the worst. I really want to be able to cast Sunlands plus a 4-drop in the same turn. So, just Sunlancing this turn is a horrible waste of my turn. And if they trade for my Morph, it doesn't matter that much. Mostly this is just going to be a 2-2 this game. Unless they just have no removal and no ways to kill it. Alright, so here I'm going to play Watcher Sliver first so that I can play Bone Sliver next turn. This lets me block and yet still attack. Works out pretty nicely. That's a good one. So I Sunlance this. And 4-4 is huge. I guess I would just trade the Watcher Sliver for the Spore Sower. That's a pretty reasonable trade. If they don't want to trade, then that's fine too. Shade is also big enough that it can keep attacking, which is pretty convenient. We don't have a ton to discard to the conflagrate, but maybe we will later. So this blocks the Bone Splitter. It's a little bit rough. Maybe I just attack with both of these. So I think they're not going to want to trade this because they have a Despoir Thalid, but they have 3 mana up. If they're able to kill this mid-combat, they can eat a Watcher Sliver, but I have Conflagrate, so that's not too bad. I have Conflagrate for 2 this turn, but not 3. I could just attack with everything. If they block the Morph, I could just kill the Spore Sower, and they take a million. Kind of actually like attack with everything. If they have strength in numbers, that works on defense to pump their creature to eat something. That's fine. sudden death. Yeah, that is a problem. Alright, so I can deal 3 damage here, this will die, and then I guess I just have to kill this with Conflagrate. I wasn't sure how they were going to kill my creature, but sudden death is the answer. That's the thing about playing these old formats, is you kind of walk into stuff a whole lot more because you're just not used to playing it. But we're still doing okay here. I have a giant monster, and I've got Conflagrate to deal with small things. They do have 4 cards in hand, though, of course. I think I just attack with both here. If they trade, no big deal. I deal a ton of damage with my Shade. That's a bold move. Clearly they have something. Again, I'm not sure what they have. Alright, I guess I will pass priority. Strengthen numbers? Alright, so I was mentioning that last turn. This is still just going to be a trade, though. We get a 2-for-1 here. Just pass. Could play around a Mind Stab here by just shooting that for 1 with the Conflagrate. But my Conflagrate could be even better. So there's definitely upside to holding it. Okay. Well, killing a 5-2 sounds pretty delightful. So I'm just going to kill both of those and attack. I have to lose my Sinew Sliver to do so, but this is going to be really annoying. My hand isn't exactly the best here. Regenerate target fungus. Yeah, we gotta get that out of play. Go to an attack. And the backup plan here of just not dying with this is in effect. Like, if they have a bunch of big creatures and we can't punch through and we start taking a ton of damage, then maybe this is reasonable. This could be a Lightning Axe splash on red. Could be a lot of things, actually. Don't really know the format well enough to be positive about what they're splashing. Well, Harmonize is good. Their deck looks very powerful. On the bright side, we have some pro-black creature nonsense. Ooh, Greater Garganon, that's a sweet one. Okay. This can give something haste. And otherwise it's just a Thalid. Make some Sapperlings. Right, they're back down to one card. So maybe they just drew a bunch of mana. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. They literally sacrifice their whole board. They could play Greater Gargadon. Then I play this. They attack me for 9, and then I shoot them for 2. And they attack me for 9, and I shoot them for 2. So yeah, I'm okay with that. They get to even eat my Fortune Thief if they want. But the 3-turn clock is going to cost them. So do this. I could just play my land here, in case I need to flip this up. I don't know how they would give this double strike, but... don't think that's a thing. Alright, they're going for it. I don't really know what their plan is. I'll take 9. Okay, their plan was to do that attack for 9 and concede. A respectable plan, I like it. Pull from Eternity is pretty good versus Greater Gargadon. Plus, they might have something else, so that's an option. Boom Bust. Don't really like it on the draw. I do like Magus of the Disc, because it can clean up all the saplings, though it's very bad. It's very bad versus the Regenerator, actually. Maybe I just play Porphyry Nodes. I kind of like Porphyry Nodes on the draw. They play a couple funguses, and then I just play this down. The fungi are pretty small, so this is just going to eat them all. Ooh, Saltfield Recluse, Porphyry Nodes. Whew. That's a combo. See, I think the rest of my cards are pretty good. Those actually seem pretty good outside of the minus one Thalid. Although they know to kill this now, because it's only a morph. Tividar is kind of relevant. Protection from Greater Gargadon's pretty good. And then we have protection from black. Let's see, do I want to change anything else here? Probably not. I think we have a really good way to be aggressive, and then also just a ton of late game utility because we have so many slivers. Yeah, let's go ahead and submit. So our opponent kept 7. This is our hand on the draw. I think it's reasonable enough to keep. Could just get mana screwed if we don't draw lands, but the upside of us drawing lands is that we have an almost unbeatable curve. 2-drop, 3-drop, 4-drop, 5-drop. All flying creatures. Like, seems pretty insane. An Outrider Encore can buy time against small creatures with Sinew Sliver. So even if I stall on 3 for a turn or 2, our curve could still be quite good. Alright. And we can really stall on three for a little while now. I have three three drops. So the key draw step is right here. I'm going to go ahead and suspend that. I think that's better than not. Looks like they slow rolled the Mire Boa because they didn't want it to die. Because they wanted to hold up regeneration, which is somewhat reasonable. Glad they didn't play it the previous turn, though. And Tuka Shaman. Let's just Sunlance that and attack. They get to attack us back. But if I draw a land, I can play a Tividar, which brooks that. I think that's much better than trading off my Sinew Sliver. Though I certainly could play more defensively with it. Trading 2 for 3 might not be the best here. Like, if I don't draw land next turn, I probably just want to block. Because this plus this is still going to be good enough. Oh, they just want to trade. They held back. Their hand must be a little bit weak then. So I could play the Encore. Or I could play Tividar. Tividar works defensively. I don't know how relevant that is. I don't really want to attack because they have strength in numbers. And also they've shown us they don't really want to attack into our board. Outrider Encore attacks the best. If I play Poultice Sliver, I can attack with and they can't block it, so it's a 3-3. Also, it works best with the Sliver Curve out. Like, it could just get flying. Like, if I draw Mountain Pulmonic, I attack with Poultice Sliver next turn and play a post-combat Bone Splitter. Which is awkward, but still get 3 damage in because they probably won't block, and then Pulmonic from there. So yeah, I think I'm just going to play this. It has the highest upside. Wrath Trapper pretty good. They almost assuredly have strength in numbers now. Because if I attack with everything, they block with this and they get to strength in numbers. So I think what I do is just attack with this and this. By doing that, if they strength the numbers, they can make this a 3-4, but then I can just regenerate. So they take 4, and I play an Outrider Encore, which is going to block really well. Let the Thalid Legion start to grow. So they tap something. With this and this. Pump that 3 times. I could go to combat first then, rather than placing Sinew Sliver. I guess they could also let me attack and then tap my Sliver. That's kind of tricksy. Like, if they let me attack and I attack with these three, they can tap this before blocks and force me to regenerate or pump, which is an interesting technological maneuver. So if I attack with both of these, they can give +2/+2 to a creature. So they can make this like a 4/5. or 4-4. But I can flank. I can redirect all of this to the other creatures. So I'm just going to attack with both of these. Almost sure that's a card in their hand. And then post combat play Sinew Sliver, and then just keep Sliver training here. Okay, so they've decided no blocks, so let's go ahead and pump this once. And I guess just deal four. Play a Sinew Sliver. Say go. So at this point, it's kind of just a matter of time till I give everything flying. And they're able to just attack in the skies all in one turn. Although I have to be a little careful, because if this dies in combat to sudden death, then everything drops back down to the ground and we're in trouble. So play a mountain and go to combat. They let me just attack. Interesting. Well, I don't want to attack with the Shade, because it's going to force awkward blocks. So maybe what I do is attack with the Poultice Sliver and the Outrider only. Then I have both these back. If I attack with two Slivers, I can only regenerate one of them. And I really want to be able to play Bone Splitter, so I'm just going to make this attack. Also, Wrathy Trapper can tap down one of my Slivers if I attack. Like, if I attack with this and this, Wrathy Trapper can tap this, and I have to choose which Sliver to regenerate, and they just block the other one. So again, that doesn't work. Just basically want to play this game as slowly and cautiously as possible. Because we have pretty insane inevitability. They're going to have to start chump blocking pretty soon. Or just die, even if we don't even reach the Pulmonic Sliver stage of the game. Also, I would not be surprised if they have Sudden Death, that it just gets cast this turn. They're just so far behind. Which sets us up nicely for Pulmonic Sliver to go over the top. Quite literally in the air. Alright, no blocks. And there it is. Alright, so now we deal them 2 damage, play a Bone Splitter Sliver, and hopefully draw land for Pulmonic next turn. So I'll certainly just play it pre-combat and attack with all my guys. They are a wee bit flooded. By a wee bit, I mean massively. Alright, so I did draw that, so I'm just going to play this. And we are ready to attack. Even if they have a removal spell for it, I would have such big creatures that they could trade for one of my Slivers, but They wouldn't be able to trade for anything else, so... I guess they could tap a creature pre-combat if they had a removal spell. Then they would kill this, it would go on top, this would block here, and they take... Sorry, this block... Yeah, this can't block there, and this would have to trade with Liver, and then this other deals 6, or they chump, so... Yeah. We're in really good shape, even through a removal spell.